Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Okay, so in previous class we have finished, and one more thing, Sai Super sent me a file.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. Just give me a second. Okay. So have done the UV.
Sir, that's the glass doors. That's the glass doors.
That's a glass. Okay.
I didn't even like assign materials. I'll do it today.
Right selection, and this is also glass.
Yes, that's the door. Complete door.
No, this is also glass, right?
Yes, there is.
Okay. The rest of the things, let's see. So this is I believe you have duplicated the chair only up unwrapping.
Yes.
Okay. Where is unwrap?
No, sir. I didn't start it like I just like started.
Okay.
I'll do it finish by today evening.
Proceed to unwrap the whole building. Okay. Internet also has some concern about the model. I just got a small lawn area. Okay, I was thinking that some green like grass now. Okay. Okay. So basically, okay. I thought, I misunderstood this thing. I thought like you were asking about the UV. So you model this thing. So you just basically just cross check it. So yeah, there are a couple of things that we can optimize.
Okay.
Right. This is so whenever you have something like this, this is a drawer, right?
Yes.
So this is fine. This looks fine. So all the corners I can see you have added a supporting loops, which is not required.
Yes, sir.
Those things are not required.
Okay.
In game, this you beveled it, that is fine. You chamfer the corner, that is more than enough. You don't have to add all those in between extra loops. Like, similarly, okay, sure. This one not required.
Okay.
Then this corner, for this corner, it's not required. Not required. Like this is you can keep this one, but problem is. The thick the chamfer is very little, very little. So from a distance, it's not visible at all, right?
Okay.
So yes. What you can do is you could increase the chamfer value slightly, because if you keep it like this, then you can just, if you, this much value, it's not required. You can just simply delete it only. This is very little, right? That's why increase the value slightly, so that from a distance it looks little rounded. Because otherwise, if I keep this and from a distance, it will still look like an angle only, right?
Yeah.
So it's increased very little.
Sure.
Okay. There are like a scope of optimization. Like you can see all these loops. So whenever you have something like this, what you can do is you can this thing. You can see this loop is this entire loop here, it's this is required here, but it's all the way going the, through the entire model. So it's not required. So in that case, what you do is, and
not triangle,
it will be quad only. So if you connect this, so it will become a quad, right? And it will optimize the model also. Like this, we optimize. So wherever it's not required, we can remove this entire loop. Then the side loops are fine. But you can see side, we have this straight lines where it's not doing anything, because wherever there is no surface deformation. So these many loops not required, because it's not doing anything. It's a flat surface, right? There's nothing. Yes. So they, in this case, you can triangulate this thing and connect it here, or maybe connect this thing here and connect this here. So create a triangle, optimize it. Similarly, this upper, all these lines, edges are required, but side not required. So similarly, optimize this one. So this is also, you can optimize. You can like remove this thing, connect this, like this, like reduce it. This entire thing can be reduced. Like basically you have to reduce it from this edge is fine from here, because this chamfer is required.
Yes.
Like this. Optimize, we get rid of this entire loop. It's not required. Like this. Like it will be full clean model. And then what is this? This thing. This thing again, the same thing. If I connect this here, it will become like this, right? It will be quad. Okay. Now I can delete the entire loop. But those things you have to keep in mind wherever it's not required, or if you want, you can delete the entire line. If you connect this here, this entire loop becomes useless, right? Because it's not doing anything. So optimize it. So a little bit optimization is required. And this is, so you have applied data turbo smooth on this. That is like, it's your voice is echoing, so I'm not able to understand. Say it little slowly.
No, sir. For few like objects, like accidentally collapse the turbo smooth options. I think it might be little difficult for unlock.
So the turbo smooth is there.
Yes.
So wherever you have turbo smooth, applying turbo smooth is not a wrong process. It's good only to make all the edges and angles smoother. That is fine. Yes. But if you want to apply this, apply one more edit poly on this. And then wherever those loops are not required, remove it. And this pinch, this is not correct. So this part, what I have to do, I have to connect them straight, make them straight line, clean line. So let's see what I can do here is delete this. And there is a little issue here. I can see clearly. Okay. It's for that nozzle, like coffee machine, right?
Nozzle.
So you can create the dispenser or just extrude it inside to create that shape, right? So it, do not keep it like this hole, like, because you can see this hole, this hollowness should not be visible. Okay, let's see. Optimize, right? Then this is like way too smooth, not required. Slightly angle is fine. This edge, let's see, it's doing nothing. Remove. So after applying turbo also, you can optimize couple of all these loops. You can see, you can reduce it, it will become super clean, like sides. Can reduce it, I guess. It's a little rounded, but that's not required. So like this, you can optimize the entire model. So you can little optimization is required. So this will, this, what I was doing is here for this section, I'll fix, let's see, let's fix one side like this shape. This is also not required. because I have already chamfered the corners, so the side these lines are not required, but it will look smooth only if you like bake everything. It will look smooth. So turbo smooth, let's see, and target weld. Delete one weld. So it can make it really clean and optimize the entire model very easily. Now, after doing this, we have to fill this section because it cannot be hollow, right? So okay. Borders. Select the border. So I need to fill this thing. So easiest way will be if I bridge it. Bridge this gap.
Okay.
Bridge. Bridge. Like this, you can bridge most of the things and make it a super clean quad because it's a polygon issue. Like I deleted this thing from that other side. Then like bridge, so it will like really cover this thing. So it will be like highly optimized model. Similarly, glass. It works, it's fine. There's no issue because it's a round, very cylindrical shape. So we need this loop, that's fine. And let's. Okay, for this. Okay, for this kind of this small shape, it's a very small shape. So all the this in between lines, loops are not required.
Okay.
So this is like way too much. This is something, if you want to create, you can use this as a high poly and bake it. But this is like way too much because this is so thin. Like this is something you have to
Yeah.
understand. Whenever you have this kind of small detail, like grooves on the surface of something, that can be achieved by normal map very easily. With height map in substance, very easily. You don't have to do it in model.
Oh, okay. I
This
mean,
is
like a rack of plates.
okay, this is plate. So this thing can be you can see. Either you increase the distance slightly, then it's fine. Like I can, from a distance, if you see, from a distance, very little distance, from a distance, it looks like a straight line only, right? So either what you can do is, increase the distance slightly so
Yeah,
that,
there is about it.
right? So that it's visible. So I can see that a difference between each and every plate. Then model, then those loops are justified. Because
Yes,
this
yes.
kind of thin loop, we can do it with a bump map very easily. With a height map, we can do it very easily. So
Okay.
for the right, so you can see
Yeah.
if you now if you increase, you can see the silhouette. Then
Yes.
it's fine. Okay, this is again, this is also same thing. I don't know why this loop is here and these two sides, it's optimization are required. This is not required, not required, not required. And this side, this loop, this one. Not required. It holds the shape anyways, rest is fine.
Yes.
So let's see, similar manner. So this is fine. This is fine. So, but one thing you can do is like, I don't exactly remember this section. So, in your
Hey,
reference,
chocolates.
chocolates, right? So, what you can
Yeah.
do is like, you can add little variation here. Like, if this looks nicely stacked, it looks very nice, clean. So just to make it little like usually in like whenever you have this thing in market or supermarket or like cafeteria, you see this thing.
Yes.
They stack it everything like there, but there is slightly variation. So you can one or two pieces, you can just simply rotate slightly. So it will give you little dynamic volume. It will look nice, it will look natural, slightly, very
Okay.
little. Like for this also, same optimization. Like your model is ready, the model is ready. You just have to optimize the model.
Yes.
So you can see it's quad again. So you just have to fix. Like this, you can fix. So for and then this kind of shape, that is also will do. So for this guy, whenever you have this kind of shape in between, what we do is select this edge, this one, and see there's a bend here. Just make sure this
Oh,
bend is not there, and then collapse it. So collapse. So it reduce poly count.
amazing.
Shape is exactly same, nothing changed, just optimize the model.
Okay, sir.
So let's see what else is here. So if that's optimizing issue, optimization is only pending. I can see clearly for this also, this counter. So this counter, okay, it's covered with, okay, this is slab is there. Okay, I thought the whites, oh, there's a hole. Okay, now
That's granite.
granite. That's fine. So see, this is unnecessary. Delete it. Similarly, can see this entire thing with check, not doing anything. Delete it. It's not doing anything. Delete it. This is also, this can, this is something you need this edge. Delete. This is for nothing. And for this part, I'll just use again target weld and weld it here. So optimize the entire model very nicely. Now, if you optimize this, now you can see these two lines also not doing anything. So in that case, this one. I can collapse, make it a one line. Similarly, so optimization is very important because gaming, it's all about optimization. More you optimize, it looks better and it increases the efficiency and it shows like you understand the modeling of loop gaming modeling. Like
Yes,
one
sir.
single poly also will cost you, so that's why optimize. So this part also I can optimize it. So just all these things are not required, not required, not required. This part is required, but this one, if I want, I can collapse it here. And why this is, there's a distance
Oh,
difference.
yeah, that's a space,
Okay, there's a space. Okay,
it
no
was there in
problem.
the reference.
Okay, so like this, I can modify this one and then all the corners like this, this corner to here. So your model now fully optimized.
Okay.
And this, like this, you can see it's floating here, so it cannot float, right? Because
I think the granite will cover over there, right?
no, granite will cover.
Okay.
Only this
Okay,
model.
this.
You can see
Okay.
one
It's
edge,
helpful.
two edge, three,
Yes, sir.
four, and five. So
Helpful.
it becomes an N-gon.
Yes.
So in this case, what I will usually do, select this one and connect it. Now
Yes.
it's correct.
Yes, sir.
So like this, we can optimize. So it's like a scope of optimization is there. So that is something you have to check and fix it. And let's see what else we can do. So granite will come. So what we can do here is one way we can do, you can just, if I collapse it here,
Okay.
what will change? Nothing will change, right? Because that part is will go inside granite,
Yes, sir.
so it's not visible. So we can save polygons here also. And like yeah, this is same thing. I can collapse this here. No, push it here, like collapse it here, vertex build. And this one, this edge, I can keep it. It's absolutely fine. Or if I want really want to like optimize a little bit further, I can collapse it here or here. So it won't change the shape. It won't change the shape. It will retain the shape because it's all about that optimization. So optimize and hard surface portal is all about optimization. So sure. Let's see. Similarly, this model here, this looks pretty neat and clean, but only a little bit optimization again, same thing. If I collapse it here, see, nothing will change. And this loop for what? Slide just a little bend that is not required. So this corner, okay, there's a shape. Okay, then it works. Quad clean, clean. And this is your monitor. So this is also I can optimize very easily. If I weld it here, see, it becomes really clean and neat. So like this, we have to optimize the model.
Okay.
Wherever it's possible, like wherever it's possible, optimize the model. Because lesser the poly count, and you can, like if you like, you can reduce little bit poly count, and you have added this thickness here, that's good. Yep. So you can reduce poly count and add a little more detail, right?
Okay.
So if, like, suppose there is a counter or something, this side side thing you have created, it's good, it's nice. So this surface also not required because it's not visible. This is also, this is visible, I guess. Yeah, it's visible. So we'll keep this thing, but it should be, I should have deleted this thing, right? It should be like this, right?
I think I forgot, yes.
So it look like this, so you can delete this thing. So it will look really nice and clean. So you can reduce some poly count, and if you have something else, design or something, or button or something, you can add that geometry there.
Okay.
Right? It's all about that planning. Let's see. Now we have this chair floor. Let's see floor. Okay, for floor, why we have this loop?
Those are black and white stripes, like in texture.
Black and white stripes. So in texture, right?
Yes.
So why we need loops here? You can create a texture is a photo, right? So why we don't need this loops? So we can create this thing directly into substance.
Oh yes, sir. Now, I just thought to like paint each and every polygon. I thought in that way.
No, no, that is yes. That surface detail you can create very easily. Oh, this one I cannot. This is also I can delete. So it's a quad, everything clean, and I can achieve that stripes in texture. Like I can create a black and white stripe texture, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
I don't need those loops for that. Okay, let's see. This is nice, clean. Okay, there's an N-gon.
Oh,
there is an N-gon. Yeah, so that is, you can connect them, so it will make everything clean. Okay, this is one single solid geometry. So this is fine. This is only this edge and ending we can update, like fix it, modify it. Same thing, connect. It will be quad only, right? So like this, we can modify this thing. So make it little cleaner. And rest is fine. That rest of the part you cannot do anything. This is like this much geometry will go no matter what you do. But this is fine. Only the corner we can, because remember how the model like in real life, if you're seeing like photo frame or something on wooden angles, they cut
Yes.
the corners in 45 degree and then attach with another one, right? So we have a angle, 45 degree angle there. So you can create more mesh also can construct like that. So it becomes very easy and it looks like that your actual thing. Okay. So you can optimize this also similar manner. Let's see. So little optimization. Yeah, this is here also optimization. You can see all these loops are going all the way, not required, not
Yeah.
required, right? So, and what else? Let's see. This one. This is nice. You have deleted back faces.
Yes.
And now, here, all these loops. You can see there are too many, so many loops. So, what I can do here is this one, this one. Select this. Collapse it. Will retain the shape, optimize the model. Like this, you can clean everything. This one is required. This base also can connect here, like this. And this in between this line, this particular line is not there. It's not required.
Yes, sir.
So if I want, I can target weld this one to here. We'll save a lot of poly count. And this one I can connect here, and this one I can connect here. So like this, your model can be highly optimized.
Okay, I just thought like a lot the more triangles like then we might face some issues in the future.
No, like
Yeah.
triangles, like when you have on the edge angles and all. If you have a triangle on an angle, then it will create a
Okay.
shading. But this kind of flat surface, it will never create any problem. So,
Oh,
because in
okay.
your particular model, most of the things are hard surface. Most of the things are very angular and boxy. So
Yeah.
it will never create any problem. It will create everything will be really clean. So
Yeah,
let's
okay.
see. This looks fine. Your fridge is see this bevel is nice. This is good bevel. So because from distance I can clearly see there is a roundness.
Yes, sir.
So that thing is visible. Okay, this is okay. Okay, this is nice. So, see, this is a small shape, but it's curved shape. So for
Yes.
this, we need more polygons. This is nice. This is good. So, and let's see, we have what is this thing?
Which one?
This
Ah,
one
those are lights.
lights. Okay, so this is light sockets basically, and you will
Yeah.
have a light bulb or something there. On
I just thought to close it with a transparent mirror type so that like we don't get that in.
no, if you create transparent, then it will be see-through, so you can see the bulb.
I'm not 100% maybe
You're thinking of a panel light, like you have those panels and it basically illuminate, like ceiling concealed lights and all, right?
yes, highest.
So this is fine. Then it's fine. Just make sure this box, the inner box is emissive.
No, yes, sir.
MS, you have to apply
Exactly.
emissive there in Substance, and in Unreal you have to place a light there. That's it.
Yes, sir.
And this here you can see this construction of model meshes, whatever you have done here is correct. And similarly, you have to modify. You can see, oh, these two are.
The corner one, yeah, like it was like little difficult to extrude that thing, sir. It was basically a wall ceiling thing, so I just thought to insert and then like extrude, so.
Okay, no, that's fine. So that is okay, but then this all these loops, they are useless, right? All these are like not doing anything. So I can delete them clearly. This entire loop also, you can see I can delete them. Like suppose this one vertex, again target weld, and target weld is like your friend. Let's see, backside. If I weld it here. Oh. Something wrong happened. So nothing will change. This
Okay.
entire loop is not required, right? Like this, you can optimize the entire thing. Let's see what else we have. Yes, we can optimize table. Let's see, table. Corners are beveled. It's again n-gone. You can see.
Ah, yes.
So let's fix that and let's see chairs. So in chair also you have a lot of optimization scope. You can see like this corner you have beveled it, that's fine. But
So the previous shape was little difficult to modeling. I don't know, like it didn't work out properly, so I just thought to give wooden chairs as I guess like a normal wooden chair.
okay, no, that's fine. Like that's fine. Only thing is optimization. My only concern is optimization. So you can reduce polycount and all these sections. Okay, like if you connect this here, it will create really too many triangles. But usually we create those things in game. But if you don't want to create these many triangles, what you can do? Optimize it slightly. Collapse it. So reduce the polycount.
Okay.
Like it reduce the polycount. Similarly, this part also, you can see this particular loop is not required. This is also can connect here, connect here. Same thing, collapse, 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 collapse.
Yes.
This part also can collapse. This again, connect here, connect here. So scope of optimization is there. And this table is fine. What happened to this?
That's a single table. I think I didn't work out
Huh,
properly.
that is like here I can see it's clean.
Yes, sir.
Here I can see it's n-gone. So okay. And rest looks fine. Rest looks fine. And this is like you have added a decent amount of loops here. You have used text, right?
Yes, sir. Thanks.
That's fine. It's completely fine. Because this need more polygons, so otherwise it won't look nice.
Okay.
This is fine. This is fine. Yeah, that's like a little bit of your model looks overall nice. Only thing is this little bit needs optimization. Well, after optimization, start unwrapping. Okay.
I just thought to give some grass here. Yes, so
Okay, huh? You thought add some grass here. Okay, so that is something. So grass, if you want to add, so you don't have to create the grass. We can use in make. If you see Quixel Bridge, we already have grass there. We already have grass there. We can like place those grass directly into Unreal. You don't have to create that.
okay. Should I create any plane over here only?
Nothing, nothing, nothing is required. So if you see Bridge, so I'll show you. In Bridge, we have like those kind of small few things. We can definitely use it from Bridge. I'll show you. This thing is already there. If you go to home, you can see 3D plants. There's op tab. Click on this. It's like pretty heavy. So you can see all those grass and everything is already there. You don't
Yes.
have to create it. So you just have to click that, export into Unreal. And then you can just simply place them directly into Unreal very easily.
Okay.
So there are like few things. So a few things I explain in Unreal today. Like so those like how to place grass or something. So how to do it. Suppose I have some debris. Let's see. So let's show some dirt only. Like suppose okay, I'll do it in a separate scene. So most of you are creating this kind of interior scene only, this kind of scene only. So but suppose your scene have a landscape or like this terrain and all. So we don't create terrain in 3D 3ds Max or my only 3D software. We generate it in Unreal. So that is there's and plus the foliage, we don't place it manually, we paint it directly in Unreal. So how we do it? So you can see it's an empty level, nothing is there. So suppose I want to create a terrain. So you can see modes, click here. There's something called landscape. So it's already there in Unreal. You don't have to create this. Click this. It will load. So you can see it opens this tab, place actor, landscape tab, and you can see there is this entire grid. And this green grid, okay, just zoom in quickly. Okay, it's too slow. Speed, increase the camera speed, movement become fast. So you can see this green, this grid is basically your size of the landscape. Suppose I have a scene. And okay, I'll do it on my scene only, so you'll understand it better. Like that's not required, but suppose I want to, this is my scene, and suppose I want to create a landscape around it. Like suppose it's there is a garden or there is something is there, but technically it cannot be there. But yeah, suppose I want to create it. So how do I do it? I go to mode, landscape, and now I see the position. You can see the grid point. I can move it down. Either I can move the landscape, or I can move the entire model, any one of them. So I can move it, and I can say it's a huge landscape, really huge landscape, and I want to create this thing. So once you're happy with the size and position, and size can change from number of components. Suppose this looks really huge. I want only 4 by 4, or maybe 2 by 2, reduce the landscape size. So once I'm happy with this, create. So it will create a plane, and this plane is basically going to sculpt directly into Unreal. Within Unreal, you can sculpt and create the entire terrain very easily. Suppose I want to create some, it's compiling, there is no material, nothing is there. So you can see this entire thing is here. So I want to sculpt it. You can see there's a brush. Whenever you create this, by default, it will select the sculpt brush. Now, radius, smoothness, and basically sculpt the model, then smooth the model, flatten if you want to flatten any surface, erosion, like if there is a landscape terrain, there will be erosion, right? So it can be hydro erosion, wind erosion, all these things. You can see all this erosion, all these things are there already in Unreal. If you want to mirror something, you can mirror also. If you want to select something, you select them one section of the model. And strength is basically strength of the brush. Let it compile. You can see right now I can select this thing like this. Once it compiles, it will give me a brush, a circle, round brush, and then I can sculpt on this model directly. Just give a little second. I can use a tablet also, but that is not required. You can use mouse also on this. So I can see I can reduce the brush size, increase or decrease. Increase, decrease, smoothness, fall off, radius of the brush, and brush pattern. Like it's a circle, it's an alpha. You can use any alpha from like ZBrush, you have alpha, right? Similarly, here also you can bring an alpha and use that alpha to create that particular shape of the terrain. Some pattern you can use, all this thing. And then you have a paint also, and manage. Suppose I want to add more sections, like add one more section. I can add, just click, it will generate, undo. If I want to delete, undo, like this. Move, if you want to move something, resize something, you can do all those things. So it's compiling, still compiling. So you can see, so now it's still compiling. So now suppose I want to create a shape, it's compiling. That's why it's not showing the brush size. So I can create mountain or like uneven surface. Like in your scene, you have an open outside setting area, and you're planning to create a lawn. So if you want to extend your scene, this is how you can extend your entire scene. You don't have to model it in Max or texture it in Max. You just have to create the shape in Unreal and then texture this thing. So let's create this couple of things. And suppose I need to create a path. So it's too much. So for path, usually paths are flat. So suppose I want to create a path. So I'll just select in wherever you click, it will read that surface as a flat surface and then create a path. You can see. And then you can see the stretching. To fix that, you can use smooth brush. Strength, if you want to reduce, you can reduce it, make it a little softer. And just click on those area. It will soft and relax the UV also. Make it a little smooth and clean. Like this, you can create your terrain. So once your terrain is ready, now I can add like more grass and other stuff. Why it's taking so much time? Like this is the only drawback of Unreal. Like whenever you create anything, it started compiling shaded and it takes like kind of forever to compile. So it's again based on your system configuration, because Unreal uses a lot of GPU and CPU. So like you can create terrain. So in my scene, I don't have any atmosphere now. So to create the atmosphere, so this scene initially I have create the lighting for my scene. So I have by background, you can see it's entirely black, but suppose I want to, now I have created a terrain. So it should have a sky, should have sun and all this thing. By the time it compiles, I'll add those things. I'll go back to select mode again, light, I'll place a direction light. Because any open world, you need to have a direction light, either sun or moon. It should be there. Now, do I have a sky? Yes, I have a sky already. And now I need to search for fog. So you have, see, fog, atmospheric fog, exponential height fog. So instantly you can see blue sky. There was already a direction light. So make sure whenever you create a scene, you can only use one direction light. You cannot use multiple direction light, because direction light is sun. So you cannot have two or three sun in one scene. Now this thing. So sky, atmosphere, exponential height fog. It's fine. Almost compiled. Do I have a post process? Yes, I have a post process. Setting is fine. It's taking forever to compile this thing. So I can add sky and everything, fog. So you can see in fog, you have all the options. If you search for fog, I have added these two fogs. You can see I have sun multiplier, I have fog multiplier, density of the fog. All the options are here. Sun, a disk, where you want to see it. You can check all this thing. and can go to exponential height fog. So here you can see in this, where is my fog density emissive? There is a cloud option. Where is my cloud? This one only. Sun default color ground. Strange. Why can't I see my cloud and all? Did it compile? And one more thing I can add is my sky, the sky system. Oh, sorry, this the BP sky sphere. I can use this also. So if you use this, what happens in this BP sky is BP sky means blueprint sky. So it already have a lot of presets there. So select this and you can see there is a direction light, select direction light. So based on the angle of the light, it will create, you see, now you can see fog and all, cloud and all. You have cloud, sun brightness will increase, decrease. Let's see, where is the sun? Where is my, here. You see, sun direction, it gives you a sun. That means direction of the sun is like way too high. It's like top. So I can just, if I change the direction from here, if I change, you can see, change the direction and then go back to my sky and reselect this thing. You can see the cloud color, everything changed based on the direction. And you can see that it compiled the shader. So now it become black in color. No need to worry. So I guess it used some default material. That's why it created this thing. Yes, it created this thing. So I'll show you how to create this landscape material are entirely different from normal material. So I just have to fix this thing. I'll just go to landscape one more time. Paint. Yes, here it's using a material. So I'll show how to create this thing. But as of now, I'll just like quickly apply this. I'll show how to create this thing also, this material. This is entirely different material. Their nodes are different basically. So now I have this, you can see sun came here. I changed the direction of the light. So automatically sun came here, and plus it's because sun is down. That means it's an evening scene or a morning scene. So automatically sky color changed. It's a dynamic sky. So you can modify this thing very easily, and you can go to BP and you can see this grassy thing generated throughout this thing. That I'll show all this thing, how to create the texture for this thing, material for this thing, and how to apply. Because for this rock, suppose I want to apply this, I can apply this thing also directly, paint. Like wherever I'm using, it will generate this rock there. It's still compiling. And by the time I'll go to select my sky BP. Now you can see cloud speed and all, cloud opacity, because my cloud is not that prominently visible. So I can see, I can make it really prominent and visible. And cloud speed is movement of the cloud. See, it will start moving. I can make it really fast. I can do that very easily. Now you can see wherever I painted that rocky thing, it generated that rocky texture there. So I'll explain like next class how to create this thing, how to create this material, landscape material. So like this, we can generate landscape and create and polish this thing. Right now, all the angles are cliff. They look rounded, right? So usually cliffs are a little sharp. So I'll go to landscape and forget about the material. Don't focus on material now. I'll explain how to create it. Just focus on how to sculpt and create this thing. So erosion, hydro erosion basically creates sharp angles. So with bracket, you can increase, decrease the size of the brush. The erosion. Then we have seen normal weathering erosion. It will create nice edgy angle. You see, it has this nice sharp edges, and this side it's really smooth. Okay, like this, I can create the entire landscape. So after creating landscape, like you asked about the grass, right? Suppose now I want to create the grass. So for grass, I have to go to foliage. There's, you can see there's a foliage, there is a separate tab option is there. Click on this, it will open a new window. And it says drop foliage here. Like whatever foliage you have, if you want to paint, you want to create that, you have to drag and drop it in this window. So let's see. I guess I have a couple of Megascan 3D foliage, Megascan. So make sure the bridge, like how do we export? Open a bridge. 3D plants. Grass, all the grasses we have, select the grass, download it and download and export it to Unreal. After once you download it, it will give you the option for export. So then you can export it, it will automatically come here under this 3D plant library. So I can see I have a lot of foliage here. That I have already downloaded. These are all 3D model with texture. So this grass, dead grass, herbs, all these things are already there in Unreal, Bridge. So you don't have to create this, you just have to import this thing and then start working on. So you can see this grass, English ivy, there's so many variation. Let's start using some fern. So suppose I want to use this fern. This is all 3D model. So select the model. So I can select 2-3 models at the same time. So I selected all the 3D models, only the mesh, not texture, not material, nothing, just the mesh. Drag, drop, it will load it, it will load, it will take little time and drop it here. Let it compile. So now I have all these things. So everything is right now is a tick mark. That means all of them are active. So you can paint everything together, or you can just make them deactivated and paint only one or two, whatever you want. So select right now. I want to paint all of them. It will Unreal by default automatically randomize it, so it won't look same. So but a scale will be the same. So for a scale to if so, let's see if I click this here, and density is really low, 0.01. I can increase slightly. So you can see it creates everything in same size, same scale. But if I increase the minimum maximum, let me see. Minimum is 0.5 and maximum is 1.5. Now, if I click it here, it will create variation. Few are bigger, few are smaller automatically. So I can do this very easily and generate this entire thing. The density is too much. And let's see, 0.2 or maybe 0.1 because scale is pretty big as compared to my model, 2.5. So I paint it. And it won't make, if you paint it, it won't make your system heavy or make the scene heavy. If you try to like, place it manually, then it will make things very heavy. I can paint wherever I want to paint it. If I paint, I can use millions of foliage, because paint, what it does is it's instance of everything. So it's basically one model. I can see 604, 607. It's randomized the models and automatically instance everything. So once it loads, I can see, I can reduce the brush. I suppose I want to place a couple of things here.
Sir,
yes.
So whether we can use FFD in Maya?
FFD in Maya, yes, we can use FFD in Maya. In Maya, FFD name is lattice.
Okay, sir.
Like when you use like your FFD, you can see there is a lattice point option, right? In Max.
Actually, I'm not used it, sir. I will try it today.
Okay, so in Max, the FFD, when you apply FFD, if you go and select in modifier, it will show you a lattice point. So in Maya, the name of the FFD modifier is lattice. It's under deformer. There's a deformer. There's a deformer menu is there. Under that, there is a lattice option is there.
Okay.
So, yes, you can use that. So I can paint. It's almost compiled. See, only two. So now you can see it's compiled. You can see the texture and plus animation. It's moving also. So how to create this animation also, that is also I'll explain. This is the animated material. It's just a material. There's no animation in real reality. So you can create this thing and make it really simple. And if I go back to my select and play this, hit play, I can see my entire scene. You can see. So all the foliage. So I can place a tree, I can place a bark, I can place everything and make a full jungle out of it. So this is a landscape, and foliage is really powerful. It's a very powerful tool in Unreal, and with the help of this, most of the game you see terrain and your foliage, it's generated with the help of this. They don't create it manually, they generate it like this. And now you can paint whatever you want to paint. You can paint tree, like suppose I have some trees, let's see. I have some tree. I have some tree. Not this one. Now there is a package I have. Some jungle, tropical jungle, yes. Tropical jungle foliage. So I have all these foliage. Suppose I want to paint something, I have to go back to foliage again and select all of them, deactivate this thing. Now it won't paint this. I select, suppose, this one, these three, and I want to paint this. Just drag, drop this thing. And this particular package, you can see Tropical Jungle package. It's downloaded from an Epic marketplace. It's a free pack, free, what do you call it, project. So you can download this thing. And like it have a lot of foliage, nice foliage. You can use that and drop it here. Then tick mark, switch on them and select all three of them because variation is required. So you can see by default, it have option number 1, 1.5. It's there. Now, if I want to paint something, I can cover this entire thing. It feels too big, so maybe 0.52, 1, let's see, 1 also too big, 0.7 to 0.2. Okay. Now I can paint. I can make a convert this into a tropical forest. You can see this everything like all there are only three models, but it looks so dynamic. It looks so like there's so many variation. I'm just covering all the borders, so it will give me a little dynamic shape. It doesn't look like it should not look like abruptly finished. So just closing those sections. That will load. Select. Now if I hit play, it's compiling. It might take a little time or might crash also. So,
sir.
Yes.
So these trees are like not any physical things, right?
No, these are like these trees are there. It just these trees are instance, and okay. You paint it. So you can, if you want to collide right now, there is no collision. For this tree, there's a collision. I guess the smaller one doesn't have any collision here. Leaves doesn't have any collision, so I can. If I want, I can generate collision also. As you can see, it's creating this thing, it becomes super easy. I can make a full scene out of it very easily.
Yes.
So you can see like instantly the entire scene look change because now you have an entire landscape. You have trees, foliage, and leaves are also moving. So it looks very nice.
Yes.
So I'll explain how to do all this thing, how to create materials, like your landscape material, this moving, your animation material and all this thing. I'll explain how to create. Can do that very easily. Okay, so we'll do that. Just give me a second. I'll take attendance. Type shit for time extended. I have to. And the class, just give me a second. I'll take attendance. Let's see, Balaji, Chintan, Rajit, Sai, Supraj, all five are present. Very nice. Okay. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. So like this, you can try. I'll explain it tomorrow, day after tomorrow, I guess. So whenever the class will meet, and I'll explain how to create the material for this landscape and plus how to create this moving texture and all, how to create those things. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. What happened to my Zoom?